2 Corinthians 3:7. Now the ministry of death, carved in letters of stone, came to such glory that the Israelites could not gaze at Moses' face because of its glory, which was being brought to an end. Will not the Spirit have even more glory? For if there was glory in the ministry of condemnation, the ministry of righteousness must far exceed it in glory. Mm. Are we living anywhere near to where Moses was? Where his face was shining?
Yeah.
I don't think so. But with the Holy Spirit, our faces should be shining far more than the face of Moses. That is the potential we have. Isaiah 51 verse 9. Awake, awake, put on strength. And we need to wake up now before it's too late. The world is falling apart around us through sin, and only Jesus is the answer. And if we have Jesus living within us, then we have the answer to every problem in the world. And we need to put on the garments of strength now. So now you've got your basic garments of salvation and righteousness. You've got now your basic garments of the fruit of the Holy Spirit, and we now come towards the outer garments, the garment of strength. And we need to put on the garment of strength now. And this corresponds with loving the Lord with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind, and all your strength, which is the first commandment. Loving Him with your heart in our daily lives. Loving Him by yielding our soul, mind, and emotions to Him. And loving Him with all our strength in the spiritual area of our lives. And this is accomplished through serious, determined, and regular prayer until we are truly dwelling in Him and living from His glorious presence and love. And the results of doing this is glorious.
Amen.
And I believe that to put on your armor of strength also means strength against the enemy from the kingdom of darkness. He will go to all lengths to stop you from prayer. You should also be so strong in the Lord that He will be unable to come against you. For you will have indeed put on your garment of strength. We then have to put on our protective clothing, the whole armor of God, to fight against the rulers, authorities, cosmic powers over this present darkness, and against spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. That's Ephesians 6:10 to 18. The belt of truth which we should walk in daily, walking in truth will always protect us. The breastplate of righteousness in freedom from sin and transparent righteousness in Christ. And the shoes of the gospel of peace, always being ready to share the gospel with others. And the shield of faith, put on by prayer, that gives us the faith to extinguish every dart of the enemy. And the helmet of salvation, knowing who we are in Christ and never entertaining any negative thoughts. And the sword of the Spirit, knowing the word of God and when to use it. And this is all put on with the word of God. So the first two pieces of the armor is truth and righteousness. And this corresponds with the two first fruits of the Spirit, salvation and righteousness. Isn't that interesting? And these protective garments come along with the basic and inner garments is a clothing that Revelation 3:18 is talking about, that makes us rich in white raiment, the only clothing that can clothe our nakedness in the spiritual realm. And we all know the value of the armor of God, but we have to put it into practice. For we battle against the spiritual forces of darkness. And lastly, we need to wear our wedding garment. Matthew 22:11-14. But when the king came to look at his guests, he saw there a man who had no wedding garment. And he said to him, "Friend, how did you get in here without a wedding garment?" And he was speechless. Then the king said to the attendants, "Bind him head and hand and foot and cast them into outer darkness. In that place there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth, for many are called, but few are chosen." We need to put on our wedding garment. In Israel, your wedding garments are produced by the host. And it's the same in the spiritual realm. Our wedding garment is given to us by our host, the Lord God of heaven, but we have to put it on. You see, this man was not prepared for the wedding feast. He was not wearing his wedding garment of righteousness. He had no heavenly clothing covering him. He may have been called, but he did not prepare himself for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Therefore, he was not chosen to enter the wedding feast. And we need to examine ourselves and make sure we are preparing ourselves and putting on our heavenly garments daily, to be clothed with white raiment, which is our wedding garment, is to wear, number one, our basic garments of salvation of who we are in Christ. Two, our second basic garment of righteousness through truly living out our Christian lives. Three, our inner garments, which are the fruits of the Holy Spirit, love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control, compassion, humility, and humbleness are also the fruits of the Spirit. And these are all the fruits of love. So how do we put these garments on? Through loving God, our Father, through Jesus Christ, His Son, through yielding our lives to Him. Four, our outer garments of wisdom and strength, by wearing the armor of God. Now you don't just look beautiful in your garments of splendor, but you're also clothed with the armor of God to protect you against every possible attack of the enemy. And now you will be fully clothed with strength and splendor. And five, our outer garments of godliness, honor, and majesty, which will shine through us. Clothing that is imperishable, and will clothe our mortal bodies with immortality for eternal life with Christ. For now, we will be at last fully clothed in the Lord Jesus Christ. So to summarize, one, our basic garments of salvation and righteousness. Two, our inner garments of love. Three, our outer garments of wisdom. And lastly, our covering garments of godliness.
Hallelujah.
So let's walk in salvation, righteousness, love,
hallelujah,
wisdom, and godliness.
Amen.
We will all have to stand before our Lord,
yeah,
the King of Kings, one day. Are we sufficiently prepared? Are we sufficiently clothed? It is through Jesus Christ our Lord and what he has done for us on the cross that enables us to enter through the gates into heaven to eternal life. And we need to prepare ourselves now for the greatest event of our lives. And this we do in Christ in prayer daily. Esther spent a lot of time before she went to the king by rubbing in oils into her skin before she could stand before an earthly king. How much more do we need to prepare ourselves now to stand before the King of Kings and Lord of Lords? This is the only clothing that will go with us to heaven. Our earthly clothing will no longer clothe our bodies. We need to prepare ourselves now with the positive clothing that will go with us. Amen. And get rid of any negative rags from the kingdom of darkness. It is our characters that speak of whether we are wearing the positive, beautiful clothing from heaven or the rough rags of hate and sadness and unrest and impatience and unkindness and wickedness, unfaithfulness, cruelty and loss of control. All of this clothing speaks of poverty. In heaven, it's our spiritual clothing that speaks of how rich we are in Christ. If we are spending too much time gathering earthly riches at the cost of heavenly riches, we will become more and more poor spiritually. Have we put enough thought into where we are going? Have we prayed about it before the Lord? Are we making the necessary changes in our lives in order to be able to wear our heavenly garments here on earth? Will the Lord be able to crown us with these crowns if we are not wearing the garments? No crown can come upon us. So how do we put these garments on? Through loving God our Father, through Jesus Christ himself. Amen. Through yielding our lives to him through the Holy Spirit. Amen. By living in a relationship in prayer. Yes. Through putting him first in our lives. And through his grace alone, we will then walk more and more in him. Learning to wear each garment more easily in our lives. Until all these garments will not only shine in heaven, but also here on earth, which will be seen by all that Jesus Christ has sent us. They will see them through our lives. And these are the true riches, not money or possessions. Not the most beautiful clothing in the world. And that means the poorest of the poor can also attain the garments from heaven. I'd like to read 1 Corinthians 51, verse 54. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For the trumpet shall shine, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. And we must be changed. For this corruptible, we must put on incorruptible. And this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, so the mortal we put on immortality, then it shall be brought to pass, say that it is written, death is swallowed up in victory. Just think a moment. Decay will be replaced by indestructibility. Weakness will be replaced by power. The natural will be replaced by the supernatural, and mortality shall be replaced by immortality. Isn't that fantastic? And Colossians 3:1-4 says, if then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth.
Hallelujah.
For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. And when Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory.
Yeah.
And Ephesians 6:10 says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. And the Amplified Bible says, in conclusion, be strong in the Lord, be empowered through your union with him, draw your strength from him, that strength which his boundless might provides. Sometimes it's good to read the same sentence in different versions.
Yeah.
Imagine yourself through reading the Gospels to live like Jesus. You would build up such a relationship with the Father like Jesus had. Two, you'd be able to cultivate the fruits of the Spirit who will enable your life to shine with Christ's love. Three, you'll be able to trust the Holy Spirit in total, joyful, unconditional surrender and obedience. And four, you will become fully clothed in Christ. And as you lose your life in him, you will suddenly find you have found it. You have found true freedom. Now think about living from the heavenly realm, clothed in him, while you are still on earth. One, how much more understanding we would have for others.
Yeah.
Two, how clearly we would understand what's going on in this world and what we can do about it. Three, how much more peaceful we would be knowing that God is in full control. Four, the Bible would make such clear sense that we know we can depend on it completely. And five, our relationship with our Heavenly Father will be utmost in our lives, hearing him and obeying him of utmost importance. Do you want to live like that? Let us pray then. Lord, I come to you now. Thank you for your heavenly clothing. I put on your love now. I put on your joy now. I put on your peace now. I put on your patience now. I put on your kindness now. I put on your goodness now. I put on your faithfulness now. I put on your gentleness now. I put on self-control now. Help me, Lord, to walk in these garments daily in the way I should. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.